Hi everyone, meet Amy, a constitutional lawyer. Constitutional lawyers fight for people who believe their constitutional rights were violated. Constitutional rights refer to the rights that are granted and protected by the U.S. Constitution, the document that creates the U.S. government. An example of a constitutional right is the right to practice any religion. People hire a constitutional lawyer if they believe their constitutional rights were violated. For example, if someone believes that she was fired for saying that she celebrated Hanukkah, she could hire a constitutional lawyer to argue that it's her right to freedom of religion. Today, Amy is meeting with a family of a middle school student. The middle school student named Gabe believes that his right to free speech was violated at his public school. He explains that his school told him that he would have to remove his t-shirt that said, "I hate school." His principal told him that he had to remove the shirt or would be expelled. Gabe said that he has the right to wear the t-shirt and express his views. Because he didn't take off the shirt, he was expelled. It's Amy's job to investigate whether Gabe's right to freedom of speech was violated. To do this, Amy is going to look at legal cases from the past. A legal case refers to arguments that were brought to a court and a decision that was reached in the past. For example, Amy uses the Supreme Court case Tinker v. Des Moines School District. In this case, students wore black armbands to school in protest of the Vietnam War. The students were suspended and were asked to remove their armbands. The students believed that their right to freedom of speech was violated when their school suspended them for wearing the armbands. In this specific case, the Supreme Court ruled that a public school cannot censor their students' speech or protests as long as it doesn't disturb the class. Amy is going to use this case to argue that Gabe's right to free speech was violated by the school. Gabe was not disturbing any other students by wearing his t-shirt. Amy also uses the Supreme Court case Hazelwood School District et al. Versus Kollmeyer. In this case, students wrote articles for a school newspaper. The articles were removed by the school because the school thought they were not appropriate. The students believed that their right to free speech was violated. In this case, the Supreme Court ended up siding with the school. The court said that the school could decide what should be printed in the school newspaper and determine if it was appropriate for students. This case shows Amy that some speech is not protected in schools. This case was an example of a school being able to stop speech that they believe is inappropriate or disruptive to students. Amy continues to look for legal cases that discuss students' free speech in schools. Her goal is to put together evidence that shows that Gabe was exercising his right to freedom of speech and expression in a public school. Amy hopes that she wins the case and proves to the court that Gabe's t-shirt did not disturb his class and that the school was violating his First Amendment rights. Now it's your turn to go on an adventure and think like a constitutional lawyer.